students, welcome to the class on editorial decode, and in this class I will be decoding the stifling steel framework written by Pulappurai Balakrishnan. Now this editorial is important for public administration optional students, political science optional students, and this will also help you in your general studies mains examination paper 2 and paper 4. Now in this editorial, I will be discussing three things. The first is about the bureaucracy. And the second is about bureaucracy and development. Bureaucracy and development. And the third thing is about the changes that are required in bureaucracy. What kind of changes do we need in bureaucracy? Now, let us discuss what is meant by bureaucracy. Now, bureaucracy is a kind of an administrative carrying process. It is an administration carrying activity. It is a process. It is a way of conducting governance. It is a way by which the government implements its policies. So it is a mean, it is a process, it is a structure. Now, what in essence is meant by bureaucracy? Bureaucracy is a kind of administrative setup. Bureaucracy is a kind of an administrative system in which the functionaries, they are arranged in hierarchy. You have a manager, you have a clerk, you have a PM. There is a hierarchy of the functionaries. There is a hierarchy of the personals in bureaucracy. And these personals are expected to perform their rules, their functions as per the rules, laws and regulations. And these rules, laws and regulations, they are actually written. In bureaucracy, the functionaries, means the personals, they don't have the freedom, they don't have the autonomy, they don't have the leeway to disregard these rules, regulations and laws. So the entire thing, the way the administration is run in bureaucracy, it is run according to the rules and regulations. You don't have a kind of your own autonomy. You don't have a lot of discretion in your decisions. Your choices and your decisions are based only on the rules and regulations. Now, this bureaucracy, from this editorial's perspective that we're discussing, it has become a stifling block for the development in India. Now, why it has become a stifling block? First of all, this bureaucracy as a concept, it is not sui generis. What is meant by sui generis? Sui generis means something that has grown from within the country. The bureaucracy, it was supplanted by the Britishers in India. The bureaucracy was an alien concept till 1850s. Indians were not aware about what is meant, what is bureaucracy. Though it had existed in some pseudo forms, but more or less they were lacking in the awareness of what was meant by bureaucracy. So this bureaucracy was supplanted. Theoretically, this is one of the most rational kind of administrative system. Theoretically, I'm talking about. But practically, this system has more aberrations. Now, why it has got more aberrations? It has got more aberrations because the bureaucracy that was supplanted in India, on it was imposed two such goals that had made it to degrade. Now, what were those goals? The number one goal was the extraction of the financial benefits, the extraction of revenue. Now, this role was fixed onto bureaucracy, and the second goal was the maintenance of law and order situation. Law and order situation function and the function to extract the financial benefits. Now both these functions had made bureaucracy quite a powerful institution, and it had acquired certain kind of ethos and ethics which has made it incompatible to the development that is required in a country like India. A nation like India requires effective administration, it requires economic administration, it requires administration that is responsive to the needs of the people. It requires administration that is open. It requires administration that is change-oriented. It requires administration that is flexible. You don't require administration that is just clogged to the rules, to the laws, and to the regulations. Now, when you get clogged to these rules, laws, and regulations, your administration, your decisions, your actions, your activity becomes chaos. You become indifferent to the needs of the people. You become ascendantic. You become hegemonic. You become red tapist. You tend to slow down the things. Now, when India got its independence, bureaucracy was the sole institution that was a strong one. When you compare it with the institutions of civil society and the institution of the political leaders. Now this political class was quite weak. This political class was quite amateurish during 1950s, 60s, 70s. Whereas this bureaucracy, it was a quite professionalized class. A class that had an experience. A class that knew how to conduct administration. A class that knows ins and outs of the administration. A class that had a knowledge about everything. Now this political class was amateurish. It was lacking in knowledge. Now, after independence, this bureaucracy, the institution of bureaucracy, it failed to shrug off the negatives. It failed to shrug off the callousness. It failed to shrug off the indifferentness. It failed to shrug off the paleness that had attached to it. So this bureaucracy, the kind of the administrative system that we are having in India, it is actually incompatible. So it requires a kind of change, it requires a kind of reform in India. Now it's not like that the bureaucracy has not undergone any change. The bureaucracy, it has been affected after independence by Panchayati Raj system. We have seen more of democracy in India. Democracy has been percolating downwards till the Panchayati Raj level. Then the bureaucracy has also undergone change because of right to information. It has been punctured by right to service. It has been punctured by citizen charter. Now puncturing, what is meant by puncturing? Now puncturing here means their ascendantic attitude has been punctured. The people are getting more and more exacting. People are exerting themselves over the bureaucracy. The people are actually rising and trying to make the bureaucracy relatively timid than what it was in the days of 1950s and 1960s. People want their grievances to be addressed. And this redressal mechanism system has been institutionalized. The institution of Lokpal, the institution of Lok Ayukt, the institution of CVC, and some stringent laws like Prevention to Corruption Act. Recently, government has also tinkered with this Prevention to Corruption Act so as to make it more easy to tame the aberrant bureaucrats. Now, apart from that, the bureaucracy was also punctured when we introduced liberalization, privatization, and globalization. And some positivity has also been introduced in bureaucracy because of the ICT, Information and Communication Technology. The bridging of information and communication technology in bureaucracy. It has made bureaucracy more efficient. So the technology has also helped bureaucracy in reforming itself. So this was all for the today's editorial. You can subscribe to this channel. Name of the channel is Brainy IAS. You can contact me at 84594-0000 in case you're interested in buying the video classes package on entire civil services preparation. And if you're interested in joining my offline batch in Chandigarh or in Srinagar or in Pune, you can contact me at 84594-0000. In Srinagar, we are doing a batch in association with Direction IAS Institute. In Chandigarh, we are doing it in association with Raj Malhotra IAS Institute. And in Pune, we are doing it at FC Road. So this was all for the day. Now, in case you like this video, do click on the like button, do share and comment on this video. So this was all for the day. Bye bye. Take care.